Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Akhil Momin, Junior Resident, Department of Radiology, Srimati Kashibai Nevale Medical College, Pune. My paper was on an unusual case of coexistence of adenocarcinoma of appendix, a juvenile ovarian granular cell tumor with peritoneal deposit in a 34-year-old female. Juvenile granulosa cell tumors are rare gynecological malignancies. Combined adenocarcinoma of neoplasm of appendix can be mucinous or non-mucinous type. In our case, it was a non-mucinous adenocarcinoma of appendix. The current study was to present a rare case of juvenile granulosa cell tumor of ovary giving peritoneal deposits with non-mucinous adenocarcinoma of appendix in a 34-year-old female. The aim of the study was to report a rare case of coexisting non-mucinous adenocarcinoma of appendix with granulosa cell tumor of ovary and peritoneal deposits. It was to evaluate and present the radiological feature of the above mentioned appendix in a new ovarian neoplasm. Detailed USG CT MRI was done of the female, which was referred to radiology department with abdominal distension and pain. She had complaints of nausea, vomiting, loss of appetite, history of menstrual irregularities. Previously, the patient was operated for a large simple ovarian cyst in January. On current examination, the serum examination, serum CA125, CEN, CA19.9 were within normal limits. On ultrasound examination, there was a left adnexal lesion, which appeared, it was a well-defined spherical to ovoid. Heterogeneously hypoechoic lesion. The corresponding B1 image is a CT image showing a cystic density lesion with thin peripheral walls in the left adnexum, which is delineated by the red arrow. On MR findings, this is a STIR image, the B2 image. It shows a fluid intensity thin wall lesion in the left adnexum, which was slowly abutting to the superior surface of the ovary. Image C1 and C2 shows CT of the patient, which reveal a partly solid and partly cystic lesion arising from the pelvic peritoneum in the left adnexum, suggestive of peritoneal deposits. The D1, D2, D3 images of the appendix, which showed an hypoattenuating intraluminal growth within the appendix, which was in base of the appendix, and it was in close relation with the cecum. So the patient was operated for bilateral sulfing oophorectomy with hysterectomy, with pelvic peritonectomy and bilateral pelvic lymph nodal sampling with omentectomy and right hemicolectomy. Histopathological examination revealed juvenile granulosa cell tumor of the ovary with pelvic peritoneal metastasis, and the appendicular mass revealed well differentiated adenocarcinoma, which was of non-mucinous type. On discussion, granulosa cell tumors are rare sex cord tumors, which are divided into juvenile and adults, depending on the age of presentation. Synchronous primary mucinous neoplasm of appendix and ovaries have been reported previously. This was a very unusual scenario of involvement of appendix and ovary of different embryonic origin, which has been rarely reported in literature. This case also stands out for reporting juvenile granulosa cell tumor of ovary causing peritoneal dissemination, which has also been scantily reported. Thank you.